And joining us this evening to talk more about meningitis, the symptoms, treatments, and prevention is Dr. Lila Schmidt. Scary stuff. I mean, as a doctor, seeing these symptoms and the possibility that it's meningitis, that's one of the worst diseases you can get, right?
It is. It can be very scary.
And the situation here in San Diego, how many people die from it every year? Is it that common? I know there's the outbreak now, but...
It's not that common in San Diego. About 1 in 10,000 people will... have a death from it. Mm-hmm. So it is very rare, especially in the United States.
Yeah. How contagious is meningitis, and how can you avoid contracting the disease?
Meningitis can be very contagious. It's caused by, it's like any other infection. It can be caused by a bacteria. It can be caused by a virus. The bacterial one, which is the one they're speaking about, is much more harmful. It has more devastating effects as opposed to the viral one, where you're sick for 7 to 10 days and then you get well, like the flu. You can avoid it by basic hygiene. Think of it similar to a cold. Sneezing, hand washing, all those things that your mom taught you are things to keep in place that you should continue.
Now, the vaccine that's available can only work at preventing the bacterial, not the viral meningitis. Some people are a little, they don't like to get vaccines. Is this vaccine safe?
Like anything we do, there are risks and there are benefits. The risk of having bacterial meningitis, especially you hear about it in the colleges. I mean, before my daughter left for school, I refused to take her from San Diego unless she had that vaccination.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I said, we're going to the doctor on the way out of town.
Mm-hmm. Because close quarters.
Close quarters, and especially in colleges and dorms. And that's why they're talking about schools. You have 30 children, one gets meningitis, they're laughing, they're playing, they're sneezing, they're coughing, they may not blow their nose the way they should.
Sure.
And so it's going to be contagious.
We heard in Bridget's story that there have already been some fatalities. Is this caused by weakened immune systems, or is it because people just didn't catch the symptoms early enough?
You know, it can be both. If you have a weakened immune system, my pregnant women, we try to stay away from illnesses. That's why we draw the blood in the office, don't send them to the lab where everyone's coughing and sneezing.
Sure. Right.
So if you are with a weak immune system, if you have HIV, if you have, you know, any disease, you are at bigger risk. Mm-hmm. You can avoid it by the things we talked about, hand washing, even rubbing your eyes. If you have it on your hands, you can inoculate yourself. The vaccine is a good idea. It's recommended for children in the junior high school age. In college, it's really recommended. In high school, it's supposed to be required mm-hmm. in San Diego, but a lot of people have wiggled around that and not done it. The vaccination is good in that it does protect you from actually getting it. The bad thing is there are risks to anything we do, and a vaccination has a risk, small though it may be. So you have to weigh, how good is it? What's it going to prevent me from getting versus what risk do I take by taking the vaccination?
Sure. And a vaccination against bacterial meningitis doesn't last a lifetime. Isn't the recommendation every 3 years or something?
Not really 3 years. If you get it when you're about 6 to 11, they recommend it doing it in about 6 years. So that would be...